When we're acquiring data in cross-table format, we can use the Unpivot transform to convert columns into rows. In this example, we have an Excel file that summarizes quantity sold numbers by product group as rows and state and year as columns. Because of how the data is organized, when we import the file, we need to ensure that we don't treat the first row as a header. By default, the data is acquired as a series of columns with generic column headers. We can use the Unpivot transform to reorganize the data. First, we need to identify the values or combination of values that should be converted to individual rows. In this example, we want each combination of state, year, and product group to be a unique record, so we'll unpivot the first two rows. Next, we need to specify which columns to pivot, in this case all of them, minus the first column which contains our product groups. In the preview, we can see that the data will be converted from 7 rows to 45, and from 10 columns to 4. We can also choose to see the preview in the grid itself. Once we're satisfied with the configuration, we can apply the transform. Note that we can perform only one unpivot transformation per session on a dataset, and the resulting dataset can't contain more than 50 million cells. If we want to undo these changes, we can delete the entry in the transform log. Once the appropriate columns have been converted to rows, we can rename the generic column headers to something more meaningful. And enrich the dataset as appropriate, such as creating a date dimension. Refer to the other videos on data enrichment for more details. Finally, we can create the model. Note that we can refresh the data for a model created using the Unpivot transform only if the number of columns remains the same in the data source. Where new columns have been added, we need to import the data and run the transform again. Here, for example, we've imported a new version of the Excel spreadsheet with columns for a new year for each state. When we open the draft data, we can see that multiple columns have not been mapped. However, we can access the Unpivot transform again, where we can choose the same settings, but incorporate the new columns. Once we've converted the columns to rows, we can map the new set of columns to the existing dimensions and measures. And complete the import process. Thanks for watching.